A preschooler toying with the burners on his mother's stove accidentally lit New York City's deadliest fire in decades, turning an apartment building into an inferno that killed a dozen people as smoke and flames swept up the stairwell in minutes and blocked the main route to safety, the fire commissioner said Friday. The three-year-old boy, his mother, and another child were able to flee their first-floor apartment. But they left the door open behind them, drawing the fire into a stairwell that acted like a chimney and carried the Thursday fire through the five-story building, Fire Commissioner Daniel Nigro said. At least 20 of their neighbors scrambled out via fire escapes on a bitterly cold night, but others could not. People had very little time to react, Nigro said. Although firefighters arrived in just over 3 minutes, bravely entered the building and did everything they could, we did save a number of residents. This loss is unprecedented. 12 people died, including girls ages 1, 2, and 7 and a boy whose age was not given, officials said. 4 other people were fighting for their lives. Fernando Batiz said his sister, Maria Batiz, 56, and her 8-month-old granddaughter, were among the dead, though the baby's mother survived. They couldn't escape. The smoke, I guess, overcame her, everything happened so quick, said Batiz, 54. He said his sister, a home care attendant, was a selfless person who had helped him when he was homeless. People evacuated from their homes after a fatal apartment fire in the Bronx on December 29, 2017. People evacuated from their homes after a fatal apartment fire in the Bronx on December 29, 2017. I don't know what to think. I am still in shock, her shaken brother said Friday. One family lost 4 members, Karen Stewart Francis, her daughters Kelly Francis, 2, and Kelly Francis, 7, and their cousin Shantae Young, 19, relatives said. Stuart Francis' husband, Holt Francis, was hospitalized, the family said. I don't know what to do, and I don't know how to feel, said Stuart Francis' mother, Ambrosia Stewart. For at one time, what do I do? Young lived in the basement but had gone upstairs to visit Stuart Francis in her 5th-floor apartment, the family said. She didn't come back, said Siobhan Stewart, a relative who lives on the first floor. Excluding 9/11, it was the deadliest blaze in the city since 87 people were killed at a social club fire in the same Bronx neighborhood in 1990. A fire in a home in another part of the Bronx killed 10 people, including 9 children, in 2007. Thursday's fire broke out just before 7 p.m. in a century-old building near the Bronx Zoo. Its 26 apartments are home to people from countries ranging from the U.S. to the Dominican Republic to Guinea. About 170 firefighters worked in 15-degree weather to rescue dozens of people. Residents described opening their front doors to see smoke too thick to walk through and clambering down icy fire escapes with children in hand. Some escaped barefoot or in their nightclothes. Huddled in a deli on the block with her family, Crispel Martinez, 10, cried Friday as she recalled her escape from her 5th-floor apartment with her 3 older brothers. One brother's girlfriend was coming into the building when she saw smoke, called him and called police.